get his ear with the airline simulation. Okay, and you have not registered yet. So, the idea is you will have to actually create, if you want, an airline, and you will compete one against the other, and you will have to actually have 12 what we call simulated quarter. Okay? And in each quarter, you have to actually take a certain number of decisions. Okay? So the first thing, we'll have to discuss with Paul actually the timing when those decisions need to be taken, so that you have a real planning about when the students are entering the decisions. When you enter the decisions, then at one point the tutor has to log them in, so the software can actually provide the results. Okay? And you can see the evaluation quarter per quarter, how you are competing one against the other. Okay, so and it's someone that has already done it.
Yeah,
okay, perfect. So that's going to be easier for you. Yeah. So meaning what you are, and it will be there to actually help you, and he has already done that. So it means that if he's coming next week, you need to register before he's coming next week. So you will have access to it when he's there. So the first thing you are going to do is to choose a name, and that's what is going to actually keep it all together. And then you have specific decisions to make in completely different environments. So some elements about the price, some elements about the product, some elements about the routes you want to fly to, the type of plane, and all those kind of things. So you have some marketing decisions, you have some strategy decisions, you have some operational decisions. Okay? And actually the software is kind of putting all that together and looking at who has the best overall performance. We will have that. So, what is happening and what I could do is, is coming next weekend. Do you have, when is going to be the lecture?
So tomorrow, I would just do, because not today, you're doing introduction.
Yeah.
So I'll be doing introduction tomorrow as well. Let's have a lot of class.
Okay.
It's simply like you just have the airlines.
Okay.
No, it's not about losing or profits or
yeah. The main thing is that you will only have access to the student manual, case study, and getting started kit once you have paid.
Yes.
Okay. So make sure you have a little bit of time before next week when it's coming, so you have registered and so that you can go through those different elements, so you can come prepare and you can just like keep that up quickly. So what I will do, so I'm pretty sure we will go through the slides again. I prefer maybe to focus on the assignments.
Assignments, yes.
Yeah, so just the organization of how it's going to happen is you're going to decide on the dates, where, when should the decision be made. Okay. Next week, because he has already done it and he will have access to actually the software, he can guide you through where are you taking the decision and all those kind of things. So I prefer to focus on more what is needed to pass. Okay, so if you go at the if you look at the threshold standard, that's the minimum, remember. Show adequate independence of thought in evaluating the usefulness of theory in practice applied to a live consultancy project or a simulated task of running a business, monitoring performance and adjusting decision in the light of the success or failure in a competitive environment. Independence of thought. Evaluation of the usefulness of theory. Monitoring performance, adjusting decision. Those are your keywords. Okay, that's the first one. Demonstrate adequate appraisal of the complexity of management in the implementation of strategic options. Appraisal of complexity. Research, select, and use creatively appropriate business and management theories to manage and complete a project in the context of a new situation. Research, select, use critically. Creatively. Okay? So, let's see the brief. Be really cautious. It's one of these units where your assignment is worth 100%. So you don't have really, well, you have a second chance, and a second chance is just a referral. So try to avoid being in this situation. So let's see. So you have first thing, that is you will participate in a competitive business game designed to simulate a realistic management situation, blah blah blah, engaging business game. You will need to set a strategy of your company within the competitive industry. Okay. And then you will write an individual report of the performance of your company showing how theory which you have learned on the course was demonstrated both in your management of your firm and in the way the other companies in your industry competed.
Analysis where you are discussing the theories. Okay?
that we're overperforming, but we're really, really bad at doing the assignments, so they failed. And we had other students that actually had really, really poor results, but really had a reflective analysis of what happened and why, and they had a good grade. Okay? Then you have a specific question. What was your vision for your airline and the strategic plan? So that has to do more about strategy. We are really in the strategic realm. So remember, what was your vision? So go back to a definition of what is a strategic vision. What was your strategic plan? What is a strategic plan, you remember? Corporate strategy, business strategy, and your marketing mix. That's what constitutes your strategic plan. So, what did you want to achieve in those different areas? What were your company performance objectives? How did this compare to the actual performance? Why? So, once again, it's really important for you to keep track of what is happening. So when you are taking your decision, try to also forecast what you think will be the result. So then you can compare it to what actually happened. What were the key strategic moves that led to your success or failure? So you will see, for example, someone is going to progress like that. Okay? Someone is going to progress like that. Someone is going to progress like that. Those that have really just like steep points where everything is changing, that's because you have really, really, you have time where some decisions were made that had a really, really big impact. And that's what we want you to discuss there. Key strategic move, if you are just like on a continuous slope, you still need to actually try to identify what were you doing really, really well. Okay. How is the company positioned for the future? So that's your forecast. How effective was the collaboration between members of the management team? That you can forget, because you should compete alone. Important takeaways for the simulation experience. What have you learned? Okay. And that's where I would have maybe something about the reflexivity. Really, really showing that, you know, okay, that's what you are going to take, but you have also questioned yourself about the journey here. What was difficult for you? What did you enjoy? What have you found interesting? And so on and so forth. Critically evaluate the use of theory in practice to inform decision making throughout. So what you will need to do is remember not just explain what you have been doing, but backing that up with theories. So you have a template here that is kind of explaining. And it's pretty straightforward. Executive summary, the introduction, the analysis, the conclusions, and the recommendations. And in fact, they are linked with some of the questions you had earlier. The recommendations would have to be based on how is the company positioned for the future. So that's where you are kind of answering those questions. Now, if you're looking at the marking criteria, marking criteria here are really, really linked animals. So, as I said this morning, I think what you need to do once you have done your assignment is to kind of evaluate yourself using those, making sure that you know there is a link to what you have done. And if you look at what she wants, introduction, what are the aims and objectives of the report? What the report will cover and why? The aim and objectives of the report, it's not really, really difficult because she's actually giving it to you. The aim and the objectives of the report is what? Fail to consider any scenarios or concepts relevant to leadership and management. Okay? So mainly what she wants in the introduction is you need to make her understand that you understand what she's asking. That's a critical evaluation. And to provide the framework you have used to do that. Okay. Application of theories. Apply appropriate theories that the MBA toolkit from the MBA toolkit and with substantial evidence of independent reading. So, substantial evidence of independent readings, what does it mean? It means that you have to be careful about your references. Apply appropriate theory from the MBA toolkit. Okay? Pretty straightforward way of doing it. Do you still have the UIFs of your former unit? You still have access to your Brio shells? So you still have access to the UIFs. Go to the syllabus and content. That's where you are going to actually find the concepts. Does it make sense? Which means that if I'm going to, it has changed a bit, but let's take this one. Well, it doesn't change much. But if I'm taking strategy and the global environment, thank you. go through all their...
I don't even have their materials. I don't have access to that.
You don't have access to real?
No, not this subject. Maybe Dr. Nandi or Mike may have. But I know it has.
Okay, so if you remember the way it's actually framed, within this, the content syllabus is actually providing you with some elements that you want to look at. Okay? So each syllabus has some specific things. So, for example, when we are talking about theories in the TIP part, we are talking about segmentation analysis. We are talking about global brand management. We are talking about corporate strategy. We are talking about growth strategies. Those are the elements you can actually use when it comes to this part. Okay? So the easiest way for you to do that is to just like have a list. Go to your UFs of the different units that you have done. List, just copy and paste that. Okay? And then later, when you are going to actually take your decisions, decide which concepts or which theories you want to use to take your decisions. Okay? So it means that you are doing two different things. The first is you are deciding what you are going to reference. Okay? And it's deciding which orientation do you want to give to your report. Okay. What we are looking at here is to make sure that you integrate the different elements. So don't take concept that is coming just from one unit, but try to take elements, one or two concepts from human resource, one or two concepts from operation, one or two from strategy, and one or two from your, are you a healthcare student? No, what is your pathway? General? General, so that's fine. Yeah, okay. For the students that are general, you can actually take any units, okay? For you, it's going to be a little bit different because, of course, the content of what you have done in about the healthcare industry is not going to apply to the airline industry. So, but the other one was what was that? Did you have digital marketing or digital technology? Yeah, but digital technology, you can actually take some elements from there. Okay. So, what I would do is look at the pole, the polarization. What is an A? What is a fail each time? So the fail here would be very little or no attempt to use MBA toolkits, no evidence of understanding any key issue and concepts. But automatically, if you have selected your concepts at the beginning and you have referenced them, well, of course you will understand them. Maybe not 100%, and she will still say, no, that's not 100%, that's not an A, but you won't be in this position because you already have your concept listed and you already know what you want to look at. Analysis. Critical analysis that explore in-depth implication of issue highlighted, supported by appropriate evidence. Your evidence evidence will be based first on the results you are going to have. Okay? And that's once again, if you want to call them your empirical evidence, that's what happens. But also on theoretical evidence, on the concept that you wanted to use previously. Okay. Now, the main issue is always this notion of critical analysis. What do we mean by critical analysis? Critical analysis is actually not only describing what your choices led to, but that's also trying to question your decision process. Okay? So it's about reflexivity. Why did you take those decisions? Have you changed at some point? Maybe you were going for a strategy that wasn't working and you decided to change. And all those different elements. It's not just describing what happened, it's making sure you see the implication of the decision you have taken on the result. Random collection of statements with no attempt to use evidence to support the argument, nothing of value to the task. Okay? So that's once again here where you are asking yourself the answer what question. Why do I need to say that? What is the value of what I'm saying? How is that helping me to critically evaluate theory in practice? Because remember, that's your aim. Conclusion. Conclusion are valid and clearly derived from in-depth critical analysis. So once again, once you have done your critical analysis, then you can actually say those are the implications, that's the conclusions. And once I know that, that's linked with your recommendation, what do I propose for the future? Presentation clearly and concise. And
comprehensive bibliography, reports for us, sources for us. So nothing we bring over there.
Once again, as I said this morning, before you submit, try to grade yourself, try to switch, give your report to another student, ask him or her to grade you, do the same thing for the other student, so you can know what's going on, where you are. That would be specifically interesting where you are thinking you are doing really, really well and the other students is saying, and most of the time you tend to be harsher than we are. Each time I've done that with my students, they are really, really harsh. That's mainly it. Do you have any questions or comments? Or I think the technical stuff of how you monitor the decision and stuff like that will be covered next week because they already have done it. So and it's always easier to do it when you have the software in front of you because I can explain it to you, but there is no real point. So next week they will walk you through all that. The only thing is we need to make sure that they are registered. Before you are coming next week.
Okay.
if you're looking at what is said is
this is a scenario.
Yeah. Look at the second one. What were your company's performance objectives? Okay? So it means that when you are taking a decision, you have an objective. Okay? If you are like me, you are going to take some decisions, and when you will have to actually write down your assignments, you are going to say, well, what did I do? I don't remember. When you are taking decisions, just keep a track of what was the decision, why. So what was the decision, you will be able to actually look at it online. That's not a problem. You will have, you will be able to see the decision you have taken. But what you will lose is why you have taken that decision at that time. Okay? So the first decision you will have to take, for example, is do you want to compete in low cost, do you want to compete in luxury, or do you want to compete in middle range? That's the first decision. Okay? So you need to actually think, when you are going to take that decision, why do you want to take that decision? We try to avoid middle range, just for you to know. Okay? Why are we avoiding middle range? Which are the best airline? Which are the airlines that are performing best?
Budget airlines and
low cost are
two airlines just shut down. I don't know. The Mandalay, they stopped running. Evergrande and Mandalay. And then now it's the best ones my
actually And it's a dynamic environment, which means that it's looking at all the decisions you are taking, but that also put them in contrast with the decision the other players are taking.
Yeah.
to do with healthcare, then it's maybe business, yeah, other units.
At the business level, and you want to be a low cost.